So today we will be talking about trade-offs and foraging in ecology. Animals have a finite amount of time and energy to use to accomplish a number of tasks, including finding food, mates, and shelter. Therefore, examining when, where, and how animals choose to spend their time can give insights into an animal's environment and their life history priorities. So foraging in ecology. During foraging, animals must spend energy, costs, to consume and gain energy, benefits. Now, knowing what factors of foraging can affect costs and affect benefits are important. So for costs, we have distance traveled, handling time, stationary versus mobile prey, predation risks. And for benefits, we have nutrient content, prey size, prey abundance and density. And if animals are foraging optimally, the benefits will outweigh the costs. So we also have another theory, the patch use theory. And we can recognize that animals live in heterogeneous environments where resources and are patchily distributed, and shelter is found in one place, water in another, while predators roam in between different patches. So the patch use theory predicts that a foraging animal will cease using a patch when the cost of foraging exceeds the benefits. Costs may include distance traveled in between patches, potential for predation, or the quality of the resources gained. So we can visualize this using the marginal value theorem, where we have patch distance and its influence on the giving up time, the amount of time an animal will spend in a patch before it moves on. So on the x-axis, we have time, and on the y-axis, we have total energy gain. Now our red line, or one of the lines in the graph, will represent the observed giving up time. Our yellow line will represent our theoretical giving up time. Where these two meet is the actual predicted giving up time of the animal. And so we can assume that giving up time will be shorter when patches are closer together because animals are able to freely roam in between patches and it may be safer to do so. And there's more food at different patches. So our giving up time observed is shorter. Our theoretical giving up time is also shorter. Therefore, if the patches are closer together, our theoretical giving up time will be shorter. So giving up density refers to the amount of food remaining in a patch when an animal gives up to move on to a different patch. Patches which are relatively safe or more preferred will have a lower giving up density, which means very little food is left behind and there are a lot of foragers. Patches which are riskier or less preferred typically have a higher giving up density, meaning more food is left behind and there are fewer foragers in the patch. So what factors can affect an animal's foraging decisions? We have external factors like prey availability, risk of predation, social interactions, habitat structure, and the availability of thermoregulatory opportunities. We have internal factors like hunger, learned experiences, age, sex and reproductive state, epigenetic inheritance, dietary preferences. And we have historical or phylogenetic factors like sensory limitations, morphological characteristics, physiological parameters, and behavioral sets.